गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू आर ऑल डूइंग वेल। Today we will start the session, right? So yesterday we are discussing about wind pressure on chimneys, isn't it? So yesterday we are discussing about wind pressure on chimneys, right? So we will continue the same, and we will try to solve problems on chimneys. They are very important even for your external examination point of view. Okay. Right. Let's move on to some important parameters in the chimneys. Okay. Then we will try to write down the formulas. Okay. And we will see what will be the stress distribution taking place in the chimneys. Because in the previous problems we came to know what is direct and bending stresses. Right. And today we are going to solve the same kind of problems. How to calculate the direct and bending stresses in the applications like chimneys, retaining walls and dams. Okay, masonry dams. Okay, right. So let me share the screen. Okay. So as we are discussing how to calculate wind pressure on chimneys. Okay, so as we discussed yesterday, so chimneys are tall structures, so which are subjected to horizontal wind pressure, isn't it? So basically chimneys will be see, if you're coming in between it will take time. Okay, so basically chimneys are very tall structures, so usually they will be either a circular cross section or either in a square or a rectangular cross section. Okay, so in that way chimneys are basically tall in structure. Okay, and they are subjected to, as they are tall, they are subjected to basically wind pressure so of kilonewton per meter square. Okay. Okay, so as the chimneys are having some particular height, isn't it? Right, so this is how the chimneys are subjected to wind pressure. So due to the self weight of chimneys, due to its self weight, right, direct stress will develop in the chimney due to the self weight. Direct stress will develop due to wind pressure, bending moment will develop. Okay, bending moment will develop, which is going to create a bending stress in the member. Okay, so the combination of these two is nothing but combined stress. Okay, so this is what we are going to calculate for even for the chimney also. Okay, right. Okay, this is what happens in the chimneys. But here there are few important note points which we have to remember. One thing is, as the chimneys are basically tall in structures which are having in different cross sections, so the exposed area, if the area exposed in the chimney, okay, if the area exposed due to the chimney to the wind pressure, so which is curved, So if the chimney's surface area is in the form of a curved shape, what happens? Okay, the magnitude of the force will be less than when the area of the surface is flat surface. So that means curved chimneys means surface area. The surface area of the curved chimneys will be less magnitude compared with area of flat surface. Okay, so that is the reason why if you see any chimney, usually all tall chimneys will be in a circular shape. Enduku? Because circular shapes chimneys will have very less wind effect on matter. Okay, the wind pressure distribution will be very easy in the curved surface. So that's why it will have very less magnitude compared with the flat surface of the chimney. Okay, so that is very important where we have to understand. And when the chimneys are subjected to wind, what happens? There some wind resistance will take place. Okay, so when the tall structures are subjected to wind force or wind pressure, the member will have a wind resistance. So that is going to be considered as a reduction factor and under. Okay, so when the chimneys are subjected to wind pressure, there will be some reduction factor. The reduction factor is indicated with the symbol K. Okay, so this reduction factor always depends upon the shape of the area of the chimney. Exposed to wind, okay, whether it is a circular cross section or whether it is a flat surface, based on the exposed area due to the wind effect, the reduction factor is going to be considered. This reduction factor K is based on the shape of area exposed to the wind. So that reduction factor is going to be called as a coefficient of wind resistance under. Okay. So please, very, very important. So these three are very, very important. Okay. When the tall structures are subjected to wind, there will be some reduction factor K is going to be considered. This K is always depends upon the shape of area exposed to the wind. What is that area? Whether it is a curved area or whether it is a flat surface, and it depends on it. So that is going to be called as a coefficient of wind resistance under. Okay, so this coefficient of wind resistance will varies based on the area exposed to the wind. So usually what happens, please try to note down these points. Note 0.5 to 0.75. okay, so these are the K values for cylindrical shafts. Okay, for cylindrical chimneys eppudaina ee cylindrical shape lo unnai ankonde, the K is going to be considered as 0.5 to 0.75 value madhyalo manam teeskovachchu. Okay, right. And but for the other usually K value will vary in between 0.5 to 0.75. Okay, this is the general condition of K. And K value is general 0.5 to 0.75 majlo untundi. Okay. But what happens to the cylindrical section? Cylindrical sections ki your K value will be will be around 2 by 3 untundi. Okay, your k value will be around 2 by 3. What do you mean 2 by 3? How much will be the 2 by 3 amma? So 2 by 3 value will be specially for cylindrical section, so which is going to be around 0.66 value untundannamata cylindrical sections ki. Okay, but for other sections like flat surface and all, usually it will vary in between 0.5 to 0.75. Okay, so these two please try to remember for your competitive exams. Okay, the reduction factor k is always depends on the shape of the area exposed to the wind, so that is called as a coefficient of wind resistance antaru. So that k usually varies between 0.5 to 0.75. generally for cylindrical sections your k value will be 0.66 anamata. 0.66 ante 2 by 3. Okay, 0.66 ante the 2 by 3 value. Okay, so that you have to understand. Yeah, and next one, so basically the chimneys availability will be in a hollow sections lo untai, square sections lo untai, okay, and a hollow circular sections lo kuda untai. Hollow circles, hollow square. Okay, so these are the availabilities of the different cross sections of the chimneys. So basically these cross sections may be uniform throughout the height, or it may be tapered towards the top also. Okay, these cross sections usually will be available like this. Like this means it will be like straight. Okay, undachu, or else it will be like a tapered also. Okay, usually chimneys will be available in these two ways. Okay, so this is called uniform cross section throughout the height of the member. This is called a tapered cross section throughout the height of the member. Okay, so these are the availabilities of the chimneys. Chimneys usually available in different cross sections like hollow square, square, hollow circle. Okay, so in that way, so it is not like a solid. Enduku solid anatledu, because usually chimneys are used for what? For flumes kada, gas flumes ni baitiki entry cheyadam kosam use chestaru. Understand? Okay, in that way it should be hollow. Okay, it should be have some gap in between. So that is how the chimneys are going to be made. So now, very very important, where you people should understand very clearly, let us take one a rectangular chimney. Okay, so which is subjected to wind. Okay namma, and this is support, and this is height of the chimney, and this is your wind pressure kilonewton per meter square. Okay, wind. So now due to this wind, can you tell me what will be your, so this will have a self weight W. Okay, so this will be subjected to direct stress plus bending stress. Rendu untai deentlo avuna. Okay, M by Z. Okay, can you tell me at which portion of the chimney will have the maximum stress? If you draw the stress distribution diagram for this, ekkada ekku stress untundamma due to this wind load, where the maximum stress will develop? E point lona, E point lona, E point lona. Which point will have the maximum stress? Meeru okasari practical ga alochinchandi. Due to this wind, this chimney will try to bend like this. Avuna? Please try to imagine practically like this. So where will be the maximum stress develop? So this is the point where maximum stress develops. Okay, so by that your stress diagram will be like this. Okay, right? So this will be the minimum stress. This will be the maximum stress. Understand? Ante kada meer oka practical aalochinchandi due to this, the maximum resistance will be at support. In this support, the maximum stress will develop at this corner instead of at this corner. So by that, this will be your stress distribution diagram. Okay, so your duty is to calculate what is the minimum combined stress and what is the maximum combined stress of your chimney. So this is what you are supposed to be calculated. Okay, so for calculating this maximum minimum stress, what is the formula for calculating the minimum? Your formula is WA by M by Z. For calculating, sorry, minimum is negative together M by Z. For maximum, WA plus M by Z. Okay, so this you have to do. But in the previous problems, what happens for calculating your moment, eccentricity is playing a vital role there. But here there is no eccentricity. Here moment is developing due to what? Due to bending moment. Okay, then how to calculate M? What is W? W is the self weight load. What is A? Cross-sectional area. The cross-sectional area of this is rectangle. Okay. So what is Z? Section modulus. Rectangle section modulus I can able to calculate. Then how to calculate M? How to calculate M? M can be calculated with formula M is equal to pressure into height. Understand? And then how to calculate weight? Weight is going to be calculated, okay, so based on the load given. Okay, so weight and Amis theorem, weight and they will give the density. Okay, this all we will try to see it in the problem. Okay, so in this very important points we have to note down. So from this, let's note down these points. The total horizontal wind force is calculated by using the relations. Okay, so we have to calculate the horizontal wind force. Why? Because for your chimney, it will be subjected to wind pressure. Kada? This wind pressure, you have to convert that into wind force and matter. Okay, how to convert that? So the total horizontal wind force is calculated by the relations. What is that? P is equal to K into small p, small pressure into A P. Okay, so here P is nothing but wind force. K is nothing but wind resistance. P is nothing but wind pressure. And A is nothing but projected area. Projected area of what? Of the surface exposed to wind. Okay, so this is how the wind force is going to be calculated. Wind force is equal to what? Wind resistance into wind pressure into projected area of the surface exposed to the wind. Okay, so based on this formula we are going to calculate the wind force. Once you calculated the wind force, you can able to calculate the moment easily. Why? Because moment is equal to what? Wind force into h by 2 times of the, what is h by 2? H by 2 is the height of your chimney. And if you see the stress distribution diagram, okay, so for your chimney, your stress will be always more at bottom and less at top. Okay, eppudu maximum stress anedi kinde untundi. Okay, at the height h by 2 distance lone maximum stress untundannamata. Okay na, so that is how we will take the h by 2 distance for calculating the wind pressure. Okay, understand? So now with this formula, let us see what will be the wind force formula for rectangle and square chimneys of uniform cross section. So please note down this first one. For rectangular and square chimneys of uniform cross section, okay, for this usually we can take K as 1. Okay, and area is equal to, what is the area of a square or rectangular chimney? B into H. Okay, so where your B is equal to what, amma? Width of size exposed, and H is equal to height of chimney. Okay, so for this usually your P ante enti, pressure will be at height of H by 2. Okay, so for any rectangular and square chimney, you can take the pressure which is acting in the chimney at a maximum height of H by 2 distance. Okay, so these are the conditions where you can consider for rectangular and square chimneys of a uniform cross section. You can take K as directly 1 and cross section area is B into H, and pressure you can take it as at a height of H by 2. So this will be your maximum pressure at a height of H by 2. Okay, so these are the conditions for a square and a rectangular cross sections of the chimneys. Okay, in the same way, let me write what are the conditions of for uniform circular chimney shafts. What happens to the circular chimneys? For uniform circular chimneys, okay, you can take K value as 2/3 unless stated the values. Okay, you can take K value as 2/3 for a circular chimneys. And what will be the area, amma? Area of a circular chimneys will be diameter into height. Okay, diameter is D and this will be your height. Okay, this is the area where you have to consider as a what is the area there, amma? Area is nothing but projected area. So where your chimneys are subjected due to the wind. Okay, and here what is D is equal to external diameter. Okay, it is very very important, because when it is a hollow circular chimney, which diameter you have to consider? You have to consider as a external diameter of chimney or shaft. Okay, and what is H? H is equal to height of chimney. Okay, even in this also pressure you can take it as at a distance of H by 2 from the bottom support. Okay, so these are the important conditions where we have to remember for solving the problems. Okay, understand? So now shall we do one problem, amma? Chala easy ga unde problems, very very easy, because we have already solved how to calculate the maximum and minimum stresses. Kada? In the same way we are calculating here. The only thing is eccentricity won't comes into picture. Eccentricity only will comes in the column when it is subjected to an eccentrical load anamata. Ante. Ikkada eccentricity emi undadu. Ikkada only moment is only based on the bending moment. Okay? Their moment is based on the eccentrical distance. Adokkate meeku ardham avali. Okay? Now let's do the problem. Okay? On chimneys. So all of you note down this problem. Note down this problem, Amma. A masonry wall 5 meter height is of solid rectangular section 3 meter wide and 1 meter thick. A horizontal wind pressure of 1.2 kilonewton per meter square acts on the 3 meter side. Okay, find the maximum and minimum stresses induced on the base. If unit weight of masonry is 22.4 kilonewton per meter cube, what is unit weight of masonry? 22.4 kilonewton per meter cube ante entamma, what is that? Can anyone, what is that? 22.4 kilonewton per meter cube anedi entadi? Guys, you have to answer. What is that 22.4 kilonewton per meter cube? Why no one is answering? It is a density. Okay, so it is a density. Guys, are you audible? ఏమ అందరికి క్లియర్ గా వినిపిస్తుందా?
Yes sir.
Please loud.
Sir.
Right. Okay. So let's draw the diagram for this. Okay. Remember 5 meter height, 3 meter wide and 1 meter thick, pressure 1.2 kN per meter square and the density is 22.4 kN per meter cube. Okay, let's do this. Amit Sharma, there is a rectangular chimney okay, so which is subjected to wind pressure of ఎంతమ్మా విండ్ ప్రెషర్ ఓకే రైట్ అండ్ ద అదర్ డైమెన్షన్ ఈస్ 3 meters ఓకే యాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ రెక్టాంగులర్ క్రాస్ సెక్షన్ 1 ఈస్ 3 meters సారీ ద ఇది కాదు కదా ద విండ్ ఫోర్స్ విచ్ ఈస్ యాక్టింగ్ హైట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద హైట్ అమ్మా ప్లీజ్ వన్ క్యాన్ రెస్పాండ్ అమ్మా Density given. How much is the density? Density of masonry chimney. Antena. What else given? 5 meters height, solid rectangular section. It is a solid rectangular section, amma. It is not hollow. Okay. The member which is given as solid rectangular pillar anta 3 meter wide and 1 meter thick a horizontal wind pressure is 1.2 which is acting on 3 meter side find the maximum and minimum stresses okay right okay so we have to draw what is the maximum and minimum stresses also so let's see what is the given data pressure p is given as 1.2 kilonewton per meter square height is equal to 5 meter density is equal to 22.5 kilonewton per meter cube avana right so with this let's calculate Let's calculate what is the direct stress first. What is the direct stress formula? sigma d is equal to ikkada load by area gaadu okay so here direct stress is you know the density and you know the height because without knowing the load you can't calculate the direct stress kada isn't it load by area kada you know the cross sectional area but you don't know the load okay you know the density kabatti with respect to height what is density 22.5 into what is height 5 meters so which is what is the value amma 112 kilonewton per meter square so this is your direct stress okay so stress eppudu dentlo untundi kilonewton per meter square this is the way how you are so supposed to calculate the direct stress for a vertical tall structures anamata okay density into height right next one what is the next one bending stress what is bending stress formula bending stress m okay so which is first we have to calculate the moment moment is equal to p into h by 2 okay for calculate the bending stress sigma b you have to know what is the moment first okay and again for calculate the moment we have to know what is p p and random ikkada total wind force avuna right so how to calculate wind force p is equal to pressure into width into height what is pressure pressure is 1.2 and width is entha amma width 3 meters what is height 5 meters okay what is the value 5 3 is 15 18 kilonewton so 18 kilonewton is the total wind force okay ela calculate chesamma so force wind force is equal to wind pressure into width into height why because your wind force is acting on which side amma width side act avutundi okay width side ante enti b okay so b is 3 meters okay at a height of 5 meters right so by that the total wind force is 18 kilonewton okay so once after calculating the wind force let's calculate your moment moment is equal to what is your wind force amma 18 into 5 by 2 okay what is the value 4.5 kilonewton into meter okay this is your moment chusara moment vachesindi right at the same way calculate what is the section modulus z is equal to bd square by 6 avuna why your z is equal to I by y I is equal to bd cube by 12 y is equal to d by 2 so which is bd square by 6 okay from this calculate what is your z value b entamma 3 1 square by 6 so what is the value 0.5 meter cube okay so now you came to know what is moment what is section modulus from this calculate your bending stress what is the formula of a bending stress m by z chusaru m ela calculate chesam based on the wind force how you calculate the wind force based on the wind pressure right so like this you have to do one by one okay after getting your moment after getting your section modulus let's calculate what is your bending stress bending stress m by z m ento chinamma 4.5 what is z 0.5 okay so what is this value 90 kilonewton per meter square okay sorry 4.5 kaadu kada idi మొమెంట్ ఎంతమా 4.5 ఆ 45 ఆ అది
45 సర్
ఆ సారీ సర్ 45 వన్ సెకండ్ సారీ 45/0.5 విచ్ ఇస్ 90 కిలో న్యూటన్ పర్ మీటర్ స్క్వేర్ ఓకే రైట్ నౌ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద మాక్సిమం స్ట్రెస్ చూసారా ఎంత ఈజీగా ఉన్నాయి ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ మాక్సిమం స్ట్రెస్ సిగ్మా మ్యాక్స్ ఏంటమ్మా డైరెక్ట్ ప్లస్ బెండింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ డైరెక్ట్ స్ట్రెస్ వాల్యూ ఎంత వచ్చింది డైరెక్ట్ స్ట్రెస్ వాల్యూ 112 బెండింగ్ స్ట్రెస్ వాల్యూ 90 విచ్ ఈస్ 202 కిలో న్యూటన్ పర్ మీటర్ స్క్వేర్ ఓకే ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే క్యాలిక్యులేట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద మినిమం స్ట్రెస్ sigma minimum sigma d minus sigma b 112 minus 90 ఎంత అమ్మా ఇది
22 సర్
22 కిలోన్యూటన్ పర్ మీటర్ స్క్వేర్ రైట్ నౌ డ్రా ద సాలిడ్ రెక్టాంగులర్ షాఫ్ట్ So at which point the maximum stress will be there, Amma? This side or this side? At second portion. What is the stress at this point? Minimum. Rundu compression or rundu tension, Amma? Rundu positive say kada? Right? Positive say nappudu enti avi?
Compression.
Very good. Compression. అంటే దెర్ ఇస్ నో రివర్స్ లా ఆఫ్ స్ట్రెసెస్ డెవలప్డ్ ఇన్ ద చిమ్నీ ఓకే కంప్రెషన్ సో యువర్ స్ట్రెస్ డయాగ్రామ్ విల్ బి లైక్ దిస్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ యువర్ మినిమం స్ట్రెస్ దిస్ ఇస్ యువర్ మ్యాక్సిమం స్ట్రెస్ ఓకే మినిమం ఇస్ 22 మ్యాక్సిమం ఇస్ 202 ఓకే దట్స్ ఇట్ చూడండి ఎంత ఈజీగా ఉందో సో హియర్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రిమెంబర్ ఓన్లీ ఫ్యూ ఫార్ములాస్ One is, what is direct stress formula? What is bending stress formula? For calculating the bending stress, how to calculate the moment? Okay? Moment is based on the wind force. How to calculate the wind force? Wind force depends on the wind pressure. Okay? That's it. So, based on this, you can do number of problems. Okay? So, this is how we can able to solve the number of problems okay second problem ko note cheskondamma all of you please note down this problem oka 2 3 problems cheddam one problem chesthe kaadu okay note down this problem we will try to solve this problem in the next coming class at least note down this evarkaina try chesthe please try it in your home and get the answers okay for the next class fast ga mana complete cheyachu read out the problem a masonry chimney 24 meter height of uniform circular section okay 3.5 meter external diameter and 2 meter internal diameter is subjected to a horizontal wind pressure of 1 kilonewton per meter square of projected area find the maximum and minimum stress intensities at the base find the specific gravity of masonry which is having 22 kilonewton per meter cube chudandi ఎంత ఈజీగా ఉందో ప్రాబ్లం ఇజెంట్ ఇట్ ఇప్పుడు మనం చేసాం చూసారా సేమ్ ప్రాబ్లం రైట్ సో దేర్ ఇస్ ఎ సర్క్యులర్ చిమ్నీ విచ్ ఇస్ ఏ యూనిఫామ్ క్రాస్ సెక్షన్ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఎ సాలిడ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ హాలో సర్క్యులర్ చిమ్నీ అండ్ ద హైట్ ఆఫ్ ద చిమ్నీ ఇస్ 24 meters it is subjected to a wind pressure of 1 kilonewton per meter square okay and the density of the chimney was given as 22 kilonewton per meter cube that's it And what is the external diameter of the chimney? 3.5 meter. What is